Today we're going to talk about how Jesus is the light of the world.
And let's clap together. That's it. Keep it going. Let's sing this little light of mine.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
All right, keep clapping now. Sounds good. Everywhere I go.
Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine.
Yes,
everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Oh, that sounds so good. That's called clapping on the backbeat. All right, sing this real quiet with me now.
Even when I'm afraid, I'm gonna let it shine. Even when I'm afraid, I'm gonna let it shine.
Yes,
even when I'm afraid, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
It was night and the streets were quiet. Nicodemus crept quietly away from his house into the darkness to find Jesus. He had lots of questions to ask him, but he wasn't sure he was going to understand the answers. He found Jesus and they started a conversation, but in many ways Nicodemus was in the dark. Jesus said to him, "Just as Moses lifted the bronze serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life." But Nicodemus was still confused and still in the dark. Jesus continued, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not die but have eternal life."
Nicodemus began to smile as light crept into his eyes. "Indeed," Jesus continued, "God did not send his Son into the world to judge it, but so that he might save it. Those who believe in him are not judged, but those who do not believe are judged because they do not believe in the only Son of God." The light began to dawn, as Jesus said. The light has come into the world. People love darkness rather than light because what they did was evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come towards it, so that what they have done is not discovered. But those who do what is true come to the light, so that everyone can see that what they have done has been done in God. Nicodemus left Jesus as the darkness of night was over, and the dawn was bringing the light of a new day. John chapter 3, verses 14 to 21.
Jesus was in Jerusalem for the Passover feast. One night, a religious man came to see Jesus. The man's name was Nicodemus. Nicodemus was a Pharisee. He studied and taught God's law, and he tried very hard to obey the law. Nicodemus wanted to know more about Jesus. "Rabbi," he said, "we know that you are a teacher who has come from God. No one could do the miracles you do unless God were with him." Nicodemus had that right. Jesus said, "I tell you, unless someone is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Now Nicodemus was confused. He thought that keeping all God's laws was how a person got into heaven. Besides, what Jesus said didn't make any sense. How can anyone be born when he is old? Nicodemus asked. Jesus said, "A person cannot enter God's kingdom unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Whatever is born of the flesh is flesh, and whatever is born of the Spirit is spirit." When a baby is born, he gets physical life from his parents. Physical life doesn't last forever, but the Spirit gives people a better kind of life, spiritual life, so they can live with God forever. Jesus said, "Don't be surprised I told you that you must be born again." Nicodemus still didn't understand. "How is this possible?" he asked. Jesus said, "When you don't believe what I say about things I've seen on earth, how will you believe what I say about the things I've seen in heaven? Do you remember how Moses raised up the bronze snake in the wilderness? Everyone who looked at it was healed. Like that, the Son of Man will be raised up so that everyone who believes in him will have eternal life." Then Jesus told Nicodemus about God's great plan. Jesus said, "God loved the world in this way. He gave his one and only Son so that everyone who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life. God did not send his Son to declare the world guilty, but to save the world."
Hi, everybody. How's it going? So we're discussing the Bible reading today from John. So it was about a man called Nicodemus. And we were going over the Bible reading there. So can any of you tell me what Nicodemus was sort of looking to talk to Jesus a little bit, wasn't he? He went out to speak to Jesus, but he didn't really understand. So
he didn't know what he was doing.
No, that's right. And what was the reading telling us about then? He was in the dark, sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's that mean when you're in the dark about what somebody else is talking about?
You don't really understand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Jesus tried to explain, and he referred back to, he said, but just in the same way that Moses held up the bronze serpent, he says the Son of Man must be held up so that people will worship him. Who's the Son of Man?
Jesus.
Yeah, it's Jesus.
Yeah.
And Jesus said one of the most famous verses in the whole Bible, which is John 3:16. Does anybody know it?
I think so. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life."
Yeah. Uh-huh. What's that mean, Aaron, that you'll have eternal life? Live forever. Down here? Thousands of years old?
No, up in heaven.
Up in heaven. So you'd have eternal life then. But Nicodemus, he didn't really understand to begin with, but then once Jesus began to explain, it says the light came into his eyes. So he began to understand then, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
And then the night was turning into morning and the dawn was happening. So Nicodemus decided he was going to leave Jesus then. And that was the end of that part of the reading. But that's one of the most important verses in the Bible. That we must believe in Jesus and believe that Jesus died for us in order to have eternal life. All right.
Okay.
Bye.
All those days watching from the windows, all those years outside looking in, all that time never even knowing just how blind I've been. Now I'm here blinking in the starlight. Now I'm here suddenly.
Going to play a little game, so we've kind of over the last wee while and stuff, we've been learning that God loves everybody, no matter who you are or where you're from, sometimes who your parents are, anything like that. God loves everybody. So we're going to play a little memory game now. We're going to start with you, Grace, and then it's going to go Aaron, me and Mummy, and then we'll go around. Okay. So the phrase is, God loves everybody who? And Grace, you start and you think of something that God loves everybody who? And then Aaron, you say it, but you have to say the one that Grace had and then the one that you have, and then I have to say all three, then Mummy has to say all four and so on, and the list will get bigger and we'll see who can't remember it first. Okay, so do you want to start then, Grace?
God loves everybody who is a good singer.
God loves everybody who is a good singer and fast.
That's right. God loves everyone who is a good singer, who is fast, and who does the dishes.
God loves everyone who is a good singer, who is fast, who does the dishes, and tidies a room.
God loves everybody who is a great singer, is fast, does the dishes, tidies their room, and is very annoying.
Oh, right, Aaron.
Right, nice and loud, Aaron, so you hear.
God loves everybody who is good at singing and is fast and does the dishes and tidies their room and who's in pain.
And
what's your...
And
he invents stuff. That's a good one. Right. God loves everybody who... I can't even remember. Is fast.
No!
Mixed up. Trust Daddy. Oh, right. My out then.
Yeah.
God loves everybody who is a good singer, is fast, who does the dishes, tidies the room, is annoying, and invent stuff, and likes the colour red.
Or flip. God loves everybody who is a good singer, who is fast, who does the dishes, who tidies the room, who is annoying, who is a good inventor, and who likes the colour red, and who likes YouTube.
Right. God loves everybody who is good at singing, fast, does the dishes, tidies their room, who's annoying, and who invents stuff, and who likes to color red, and loves football.
No.
Oh, you missed my Grace's.
You missed Grace's one.
He likes YouTube.
The girls are winning this one, Aaron.
No.
Right.
Oh, okay. You're good.
God loves everyone who is a good singer, is fast, does the dishes, tidies the room, is annoying, invents stuff, likes the colour red. likes YouTube. And Aaron's was...
That's
right. Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay.
Okay.
And also is good at painting.
Oh,
right, Gracie?
Right.
No pressure.
And no helping.
Aaron! Right, just
right, go.
God loves everybody who is a good singer, who is fast, who does the dishes, who cleans their room, who is annoying, who is a good inventor, who likes the color red, who likes YouTube, and he's good with painting.
Yeah.
And what's yours?
Oh yeah, what's yours?
And
Mm. Good to think of something for.
Who's blue eyes?
Yes. Okay. Who's blue eyes?
Okay. God loves everyone. Who?
I don't know. Who's the first one?
I think I might just give up before you start.
Well done, Gracie.
Okay.
Okay. Bye bye.
Dear God, thank you for sending your Son down to earth.
To die on the cross and to take our sins away so that we have eternal life.
Jesus, help us to trust you.
As we take your love out into the world.
Amen. Amen.
Through the darkness, follow his lead and light it up.